We are about to embark upon a series of strange and exciting, dangerous adventures. Adventures that will lead us to all parts of the world.
Hello, and welcome to another Bad Comic Review. This time we're looking at Sinestro, Year of the Villain, Issue 1. This is a one-shot from DC Comics in 2019, and is obviously part of the Year of the Villain storyline. This was written by Mark Russell, with art by Yildiray Cinar, inks by Julio Ferreira on pages 21 through 26. Hi-Fi did the colors, Steve Wan's letterer, Brandon Peterson, did the cover, which the cover's actually pretty cool, and it does relate to what's going on, more or less. Associate editor was Jessica Chen, editor Mike Cotton, Brian Cunningham, group editor. Okay, so Sinestro is being sent on a mission by Lex Luthor to stop something called Paragons. These are aliens from another universe. A direct assault didn't do anything for him. Sinestro got handed his butt by these guys, but he did figure out they regenerate quite a bit, and with some analysis, he figured out that inside are creatures he calls microns, which are really, really tiny little creatures that live about 0.8 milliseconds. Now, when he tries to confront them a second time, he sends little avatars of himself through his ultraviolet ring powers into them, and it doesn't really work. But one of the avatars observed rather than trying to influence, and he learned quite a bit. So he uses a really interesting idea to try and win, more or less, and it works. Not going to give it away, but he ends up doing something really interesting that lets him get the result that he desired, not necessarily the one Lex Luthor desired. Overall, this was an okay story. It's kind of slow, and parts of it were kind of dumb. There's definitely some really kind of lazy politics in here, but overall, I would say it's worth reading if you're into the Year of the Villain stuff, just to be a completionist, but for the cover price, it's definitely not worth $5. I picked this up out of a dollar bin, and I think that's a fair price for it. Anything over $2 for this is probably going to be a waste of money. The story wasn't that original, and the idea behind it was good, but it was just poorly executed, and it felt very lazy the way that the resolution happened, because it's more kind of rushed at the end. Some of the beginning could have been compressed to make way for a longer explanation as to how Sinestro was going to defeat the creature, rather than doing it through a flashback, which was really lazy. So it's a good idea for a story, but it's really kind of lazily completed. So I wasn't particularly impressed with the way it was executed. It was just okay. So if you can find this for a buck or two, then I'd say pick it up, maybe, if you're a completionist. It's very much an issue you can skip that isn't necessary for the mini series of Year of the Villain to be read, but I tend to be a completionist more often than not, and I wanted to read it, and I'm glad I read it, but I just wasn't impressed with it. It was just forgettable. So I think it's worth a buck or two, like I said, but beyond that, I don't really see the need to get it outside of being a completionist. I would say, yeah, if you don't want to track it down in a discount bin and you don't just stumble upon it, don't bother. But that's just my take. Thank you so much for listening and supporting the channel. If you enjoyed the video, please hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss future reviews. If you want to help the channel in other ways, links to my Patreon and Streamlabs and my Teespring store are in the description. And as always, we hope to see you on the next one.